Hiya guys, this is Rainbow and today I'm going to be showing you Amazon's new cage tour. So, got off. So, I didn't put anything on this shelf, just got a bit of bedding in here and didn't put anything in there. Didn't give her a water bottle or a food bowl because we thought, well, she could drink or eat too much. Only joking. We changed her cage to the IKEA D-Off. Which is great. And we're gonna start from this side. So she's only been here for a few days. So this bedding's old and that bedding's new, so bear with this. Okay, first off, I know the bedding's not deep enough for her to borrow. They gave her a borrowing box because this would cost a lot of Carefresh. So I just feel more comfortable with Carefresh than another brand of bedding. Cause I don't really recognise much of the beddings at our Pets at Home, which are like cheaper. So we're going to start off at this side. So I got one of these not so long ago, and it was in this cage at first as a hammock. And a really cool a coconut, which she is no longer sleeping in. Then we got a cardboard tube, which you can run through and chew on. Then I got another cardboard tube, which has been there for ages. And then this was an octopus. It's meant to be a rabbit toy, but... yeah, made for the hamster. I don't have a rabbit. And here we got one of them edible logs. And there we got a cardboard box, so she's got a borrower box. And that's where she's sleeping. If I'll go and show you. You can see she's borrowed in there and she's made the little box. She's going in right now. And what will happen is she'll go in and then she won't realise that she can go out the hole, which is a disaster. But yeah, and that's that. And then we got a little chew down there. And I believe we got some carrot chews over there. Let me just move along. Got a little hamster. So here we got another little cardboard tube, and then I just made this for her. It's just a little hidey one because she does have a log, but that's too small. I've got another carrot, and then we got a bendy bridge, green flying saucer, water bottle, and food bowl. So we had her in a water bowl for a bit, but we've just went. But my dad's just went and worked out a way of putting it on. So now she's got it like that. And any possible questions I'm going to answer right now. My dad made the lid. It's similar to Erin's Animals one, just kind of a different mud and made a bit different with nails. So I'll go and check someone else's way to make a lid, if you're wondering. We made it in twos, much more easier. Open it, and then we attach the water bottle in probably the most awkward way. And I think that's it for this cage tour. Just to clarify, we will not be splitting the deed off in half for another hamster because we kind of don't have anyone who would be able to look after them. And plus, and we kind of take this when we go on holiday to the person. So, and a lot of people wouldn't actually want a lot of commercial bird cages don't actually have two levels, so it's kind of hard to find. Oh no, that was different. If we had two like dwarf hamsters, because I'd love them, we would have to take out the levels, so that'd be unfair for them. That was a bit off subject. Yeah, that's Amazon's cage tour. She's gonna enjoy it. She's gonna have fun. And she's gonna work out a way to escape. See, we moved her into this massive cage and still she just wants to escape. I think even if we gave her the whole room, she would still want a bigger place. Because even like this much when we pick her up playtime. Stop, because I'm like too small. So now I'm gonna give you a few clips of her being weird. Bye.